How to fix Windows not recognizing a USB device. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's dive right into what is a very common question. I have a problem with my USB ports. Say I plug in my digital camera to upload some pictures to the tower. My system won't recognize that it's plugged in. Now, obviously, this kind of thing can happen with a large variety of USB devices and situations. Honestly, USB is wonderful. I really like it. It is so incredibly convenient and makes attaching devices to our machines so much more easier. And it's gotten better over the years. But that doesn't mean, of course, that it's perfect. There are still occasionally issues with plugging in USB devices. What I want to do today is give you a checklist of things to check whenever this happens to you. First step, and I know that this sounds like a cliche, reboot your computer. Seriously, sometimes things can just get confused in the software, and rebooting is one of the quickest way to reset everything to a known state. If that doesn't work, well, again, this probably sounds almost cliche, but unplug your computer. I mean, shut it down, unplug it, leave it unplugged for maybe 30 seconds, and then plug it back in again. If you're using a laptop, if you can, maybe remove the battery while you're doing that for, again, about 30 seconds. The issue here is that there are electronic components on the machine that, again, can sometimes get confused, and even a quick power off doesn't necessarily cause them to reset. Having them be in an off state, a truly powered off state for something like 30 seconds, can often reset those components to a known state. This too can then affect whether or not your USB devices are going to be recognized. Third, plug the device directly into your computer. This is maybe what you're already doing, but I want to point out that hubs, in particular USB hubs, can often cause issues. They are of varying quality, but nonetheless, even when they're good, sometimes there's enough other things going on that having a hub in the path can sometimes just cause an issue. So at least for diagnostic purposes, try plugging your USB device directly into your computer if you aren't already. Along those same lines, number four, try a different USB socket. Especially if the machine's been around for a while, there's a good chance that the socket you're using might be a little on the dirty side, or maybe the contacts are a little worn out. Trying another USB socket, if you have a different USB socket on your machine, is another way of eliminating that as a possibility. In that same vein also, try a different cable. If your device is something that connects with a cable, like a camera, then sometimes those cables can get worn out. Again, they too can be of a varying degree of quality. Some are really good, some are really cheap, some wear out quickly, some start to crack, some start to not work. And they can work in ways that kind of work a little bit, but not always. It's a simple thing to do. Grab a different cable and see if that doesn't make the software or the problem go away. Number six, update your software. And by this, I mean, yeah, Windows and USB drivers and whatever else. Make sure that everything in your power to be up to date as possible is as up to date as possible. Number seven, this one is a stretch, but it actually plays into it. And that is look into an update to your UEFI or BIOS. A little known fact about USB is that it actually does interact with your UEFI and BIOS to a certain degree. Windows, I know when it's running, will have its own drivers, but very often those drivers will actually interact with the UEFI or the UEFI will somehow be involved. Certainly the UEFI has to be involved at some point at the beginning if your machine is even able to boot from a USB device. Number eight, update even more software. This time I want you to think about updating USB drivers. Now Windows Update will normally do a good job of keeping your drivers up to date to the degree that it's necessary. But if you're running into a problem, Windows Update may not always have the most recent drivers for your specific hardware. What that means is going to the manufacturer of your USB device and seeing if they have something more current that you can download and install as the updated drivers. Along those lines with drivers, consider uninstalling and reinstalling the drivers. I've got an article on that that will allow you to uninstall the device driver for whatever device you're doing, in this case your USB device, and then Windows will automatically reinstall it. This is kind of sort of like rebooting the device driver, except at the software level, right? You're actually removing it and then reinstalling it so that everything has to be reconfigured from scratch. And sometimes that will clear up issues with the USB device. Number 10, try a different computer. Again, we're trying to determine where the problem is. If the device works on a different computer, then you know that the problem is not with the device. It's with your computer. On the other hand, if the device itself fails no matter what computer you connect it to, well, maybe there's an issue with the device itself. Number 11, this one is a little obscure, but again, can be useful. Disable Selective Suspend. What Selective Suspend is, it allows the system to selectively suspend or turn off USB ports if they think they are somehow interfering with the rest of the system. Now, obviously, that has value. I mean, there's a reason that that feature exists. However, sometimes it can actually interfere with the working of a valid and properly working USB device. So that's something to check out. Number 13, run the system file checker. Make sure that the system itself hasn't been compromised or that there isn't a problem with one of the many files that make up Windows itself. Again, we're getting into long shot territory, but this is something else that is worth considering as you're trying to diagnose this problem. Number 14, scan for malware. I say it almost every time, and honestly, it's not as big a problem as it used to be, but it can still be a problem. Malware typically these days doesn't want to affect your system. It wants to hide. It wants to do whatever it's intended to do. But malware, like any software, can have bugs. It can be destructive. It can do all sorts of interesting things. Sometimes malware can interfere with the proper working of your computer in some pretty obscure ways. So make sure that your system is malware-free. Finally, 15, when all else fails, reach out to the manufacturer of your USB device to see if they have more advice or issues that they're aware of that might prevent their device from working on your system. I hope that helps. I mean, that's a lengthy list of things to try when your USB device fails, and hopefully somewhere in that list is the solution for your specific situation. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2445. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.